Hi friends, my name is Amrita Ghosh Kumar and the subject expert for this lesson is Dr. Manu Sharma. He is working as an assistant professor with the Amity School of Communication since the last 7.5 years. Within the purview of media studies, his expertise lies in media effects analysis, media theories and models, and cinema studies. Welcome to an interesting session on the entire process involved in content generation and the research design adapted during content generation. So let's begin with a short introduction. With the advent of and the success of online media, content creation has become an important aspect of online media. There was a time when people did not believe in the uniqueness and high quality of online content. But with the passage of years, content that is published on any site has become quite an essential parameter, especially when it comes to creating an identity of the website. It would not be wrong to say that if placed properly between the links on the social media, content creation done in skillful and competent manner can get one some good powerful links and contacts from the domain names which otherwise would have been out of one's actual reach. To start with, content creation is popularly explained as the process of creating the content which is mostly digital by nature and is created for the purpose of self-expression, distribution purposes, marketing, as well as for the publication purposes. Some of the common forms in which content creation is being carried out includes the maintenance and upgradation of websites, blogging, videography, photography, online execution of commentary, and for the maintenance of the accounts which have their existence in social media. Distribution of digital media and editing can be carried out with content creation. So, it won't be wrong to quote the description of a few surveys about the content creation, which has stated it as the creation of the material which people distribute to the online world. The concept of content creation has come so much in demand that according to content marketing research conducted by content marketing institutes, the biggest challenge being faced by B2B marketers is to produce enough content and create such kind of content that would engage the target audience. The job of content creation is being done broadly in two ways. One would include the network of all those writers that are helping the organizations in sourcing as well as producing the content with the help of outsourced freelancers. This network of writers provides the content in a planned and systemized fashion by making available several kind of software-based services. The second kind of content creation includes a network that acts like an efficient editorial team and is mostly engaged in the management and marketing of the content. This kind of network helps in creating a better workflow environment. Today, some of the popular names in the content creation industry are eByline, Skyword, Scripted, Gather Content, TextBroker, Writer Access, Zeris, etc. Also, content creation has given rise to a new domain of content management, which means the management of different processes that are involved in the collection, creation, and publishing of the digital content. After understanding the concept, the obvious next question would be about who does this content creation? Are these content creators common people around us? Well, the answer is that the content creators are all around us, and we see them very often. The content creators include, number one, news organizations, which definitely occupy the first position in the list. Some of the famous news organizations like the New York Times, NPR, CNN are busy in creating credible content which is read by masses, especially on the days when the web content falls in the category of a breaking news or a topical event at times. Getting adapted to the changes happening around is a way of life, and the same stands true for the news organizations, which have accepted the popularity of social media and have got into the process of writing content that can be shared on the web and be read by the social media users. Content creation principles and techniques have been employed by the news organization engaged in social blogging, citizen journalism, as well as involved in the production of user-generated content. The best example of and the most sought-after topic by the researchers is Twitter, which is actively engaged in manufacturing user-friendly content online. Number two, academic institutions that are into online content or provide an access to the digital library would be the second in the list. Academic institutes create content in the form of books, journals, research papers, and blogs that fall in the category of digital scholarships and are at times edited by a diverse set of academic groups. Having an access to academic experiments, raw information, publications, and databases is a great way of staying updated and knowing what is happening in and around the world in the field of academics. Academic content is broadly of two types, closed and open. An open one, as the name indicates, is available to all, and the cost is incurred by the organization publishing the content online. While the closed one can be accessed by the subscribers, which includes the faculty and the students. Number three, organizations that are into advertising, public relations, and marketing would be the third in the list. They create content to promote themselves, to communicate their brand identity to their customers, and to launch new products and services in the market. Number four, writers and artists that are continuously providing the world with digital content through ebooks, digital art forms like music, also use content creation tools. In fact, it is a great platform for all those who are new to the industry and wish to market their creation to the masses through the means of social media. Number five, government organizations are also the creators as well as the users of online content. And they have recently started exploring upon the advantages of digital content. They need content creation to make the legal information, records, and historical documents accessible to the masses. Though at times such an open access of statistical information and other important documents to the public can raise privacy issues or security issues. But in other situations, it is totally useful as it can make one aware of the educational policies, public health codes, etc. of the government, which in turn would make the government more participative and transparent, and hence lesser would be the chances of corruption. So it totally depends upon the organization that how much content they wish to upload or, technically speaking, digitize. Number six, then apart from all the categories discussed, there can be a segment of internet users as well, who are a variegated set of target audience that can be differentiated in terms of gender, age, class, etc. They are the ones who consume as well as create online content through different social mediums like the Facebook, Divined Art, etc., and inspire or get inspired in turn at times. Number one, quality. It is not right to expect that anyone who is coming online would be an expert of the subject matter, or would be an efficient writer and would know the rules of publishing. In such a situation, the content being created and being published might not be of very high quality. 2. Metadata. It is the data about the data. It can be a structural metadata which deals with the design and specification of data structure. The other type is the descriptive metadata, which deals with data content. Number 3, IPR. This means to have a right of ownership on a creative invention or a trademark or a design. Number 4, the content management system should be more collaborative rather than being based on the approval and rejection system. Rather, there should be a flow of work between the different content channels so that it can be managed properly. Number 5, usually the sharing of ideas, assignments, and proper management of content does not happen in the organization. It should be avoided and a platform should be created where sharing of all the components happens such that everyone or anyone engaged in content production and marketing is engaged in the task completely. Number 6, content creation has given rise to a separate field of freelance writers, and at times the management of these external content creators is a problem. There should be a system through which all the ad hoc writers and freelancers are engaged and managed in a proper manner. And this would include the proper maintenance of their payment system, their taxation, and legal details. Organizations like Elance, which hire a good number of freelance writers and artists, are doing good work as far as proper management of external teams is concerned. Number 7, with increasing traffic on the social media, the amount of content being created online by internal as well as external writers is increasing manifold. In such a situation, it is essential to keep a track of all this. There should be a proper measurement and analysis of the content as well as the creators. Now let us look at the steps involved in content creation. This is the most intensive and time-consuming step involved in content creation, and if handled properly, can actually lead to high-quality content creation. But on realistic grounds, since not much weightage is given to this step, so the hours spent studying for the topic on which one wishes to write does not usually give very fruitful results. This at times leads to disappointment. As a content creator or the one looking for something relevant online, one might actually look occupied for hours going through the similar kind of numerous posts, blogs, but at the end of the day may not find anything that would prove out to be of some help. If you are engaged in reading the post to stay informed or to simply kill your time, then it might be fun. But otherwise, there is no point wasting hours and not coming out with any relevant content. The research step in content creation simply means that one has to look for content that is relevant, correct, not flawed, and interesting as well, so that the end user gets all that she or he needs from the content created by you. Even as a reader, no one would like to have an access to content that is boring. So some of the essentials in doing research during content creation would be that your entire in-depth study should be to know what is popular in the area in which you are working. Because it is always good to create something which is current, applicable, appropriate, and that would grab the attention, as the majority likes to be updated and sought after, which is the latest. Some of the sites that can be referred to as having the latest information are Google News, Google Trends, Google Insights. Then Twitter, All Things Now, Bing News and Reddit are also good tools to know what the popular topic among the users is or what the most shared content on the social media is. Research does not only mean that you get and give reliable information, but it also means that you save time upon what you are researching for. To solve the time issue, there are a few technical tools available that one can refer to. But things don't end at research. For content creation, there are other important steps too. After the research stage, it's the idea generation stage about the content to be created. Idea generation simply means that once the entire data has been collected through research stage, it becomes essential to present it in the best possible manner. This is definitely a tough task and is not everyone's cup of tea. Always keep in mind that you are not the first and the last person who would be giving that information to the world. Research means searching again, and there may have been many people who might have created the content on the same topic. So the presentation matters and it should be different. The industry is looking for uniqueness, and your task is to approach the topic under study with a new angle so that it becomes interesting. One can make the content interesting through the usage of different images, or one can refer to different writing styles, such as the use of ornamental or satirical language can definitely add some unique colors to the content. Then another change in the presentation can be brought about by drawing out some new conclusions, playing around with facts and presenting them in a different manner. Simply putting it, at times you come across so many videos that show the same content on a topic, and usually there are just one or two that would bring the large amount of information under the single umbrella. An idea can be made popular at times by engaging other people in the creation process. One can create a content, for an instance, for a game, and then ask for their opinion or feedback from others. Too many cooks can also spoil the dish, but in this case, too many heads would give you different perspectives to the same research work and idea one has been working around. But this activity, if done at the initial stage of content creation only, then proves out to be useful. This might also help in the process placing and promoting your product skillfully. After research and idea generation tasks are over, it is to complete the third step, which would be the placement of the content. It is important to know, once the final product is ready, that where would it be placed, because if the content is to be placed on such a website that it would be leading to a multiple links, then the handling would be different. But if it would be referred through a set of links, then its placement would require a different kind of treatment. For that matter, after the research stage, it is a good practice to know where the end content would be placed, as this would help in the idea generation stage, and the content would be created after knowing its final place. But it's just one trick of the trade, and one can approach the content creation process the other way around too. This means that you do your relevant research, build up the content around a unique idea, and then refer to the websites that might accept your content after they realize the benefits of its unique selling features. This would keep your prospects open, because if rejected by one, then one can always refer to the other. And the bright side is that at times you might get a good feedback, which in turn will help you in improving your content creation activity. The idea is that one should stay focused as well as polite while referring to the prospective client and while working on the placement aspect of content. There are some who would confuse the idea generation stage with the creation stage. Content creation is something that comes a little later once the research, idea generation, and placement thinking is complete. Some of the common ways in which the content is created are blogs and infographics. Infographics is a collection of text as well as images and may or may not tell the story. The idea is to give information such that it is attention grabbing for the audience, and it can be done through text or graphics. There are a few issues that require more usage of text in comparison to the images, and there are a few which can be explained without a single textual element. This totally depends upon whether the data to be presented is qualitative or quantitative by nature. The infographic title should be catchy so that it forces the audiences to read the content below. The second important aspect is that the infographic should be consistent, which means that the style in terms of colors, font size, and message communication should be steady and reliable. And one must try to avoid the monotony in terms of using the graphics, which are commonly known to people around. Creativity is the key to having a good infographic. There are experts who have been working in the field, and they feel that an infographic should be placed in a portrait format online rather than putting it in landscape form. But then, web designers and web developers have their own set of rules in context of infographics. Another way of creating the content would be blog posts. Anyone who has been dealing with online media, even if it is for fun, knows about the term blog posts. The entire idea of writing a blog is to teach, inspire, inform, as well as to entertain. So the lengthier the post, the better it is, provided it adds value to the knowledge one already has about the topic under consideration. A blog post can be made interesting by adding details about the topic, putting in links which can refer to other websites that have information about the topic. One can also provide a counter perspective to the audience, as the entire intention of content creation is to provide a holistic view on the issue so that the reader does not have to refer to any other site. Now, as said earlier, everyone cannot be expected to be a good writer. So the best way to commit as less mistakes as possible while writing is to be careful about your grammar and the proper usage of punctuation marks. Start the blog with an interesting point so that one is able to grab the attention of the target audience right in the beginning. One can always follow the inverted pyramid style of writing. Also, if one is not confident about the write-up, then the best way is to get the content edited or proofread by some expert before the article is actually posted. Blogging is not just about filling in the online space, but it is about helping the readers and providing them with maximum information. So the next time you write a blog, don't deliberately just write lengthy sagas, but crisp and interesting pieces of material. Well, the story of content creation doesn't end on infographics and blog posts, but go on to the publishing as well as the promotion of the content. The entire exercise of publishing involves contacting some website owners who would be interested in your work or might need it. This also includes the usage of good keywords that would guarantee the popular placement of your content. Then is promotion, which is a stage that comes once the content has been published by the administrator. One might or might not get a good stage for publishing the content. Either ways, don't stop talking about your content. This means that keep marketing it through sites, links, publications that are domain specific, and through different social media sites. One can also explore the avenues by contacting people in the field via means of emails, phone calls. etc. At present, it can be said that like any other department that is important to the running for an organization, content creation is also something that has to be controlled, and a proper stability as well as equilibrium has to be maintained with respect to its creation. Also, proper deadline systems should be set up in regard to content creation completion, as is done for other activities being executed inside an organization. I hope that in future, if you have to create content for any online medium, these tips and essentials of content creation would be of some help to you. So with this informative session on the complete overview of the content creation industry, its processes and issues, I'll take your leave. See you next time with some other interesting topic on mass communication. Till then, goodbye.